Hi, my name is Cosmin and I'm part of the Identity Cloud Engineering team here at Microsoft. In this video, I'll walk you through some of the recommendations and best practices you need to follow when performing a SWE migration of Azure AD Connect. This will help you not only make the right decisions when applying configuration changes to your environment, but also enable a safe upgrade of the sync tool. Let's jump right in. To get a better understanding of the SWE migration process, we need to first know about the staging server topology. Using Azure AD Connect to support your hybrid setup, we import, sync, and export data between Active Directory and Azure Active Directory. This is done by a primary or active sync server. In addition to that, there is another server that only imports and synchronizes data between these sources. This is called a staging or backup sync node. You must have at least one staging server to run this topology. Only one server can act as primary. However, Azure AD Connect does support the installation of multiple staging servers that can be deployed through different data center locations. Here are some of the use cases where this topology comes in very useful. Disaster recovery scenarios, when your primary server fails, so you can immediately fail over to one of the staging servers. Second, when testing a new configuration, you can use a staging server to preview changes and make any necessary adjustments. And finally, you can use this method to safely upgrade to a newer version of the sync tool and again use the ability to preview and document changes. Let's see exactly what constitutes a SWE migration. Using the staging server for SWE migration upgrades is very important that the configuration mirrors the primary setup. This can be easily done by using Azure AD Connect function to export a JSON configuration file. This can only be imported during the initial setup routine of the staging server. So now, these two servers have an identical configuration, but they're both running on an older, deprecated version of the tool. On a SWE migration, you will upgrade the staging server to the latest version of the sync client. Once the server is upgraded and performs a sync cycle, you can validate if the resulting changes are safe to be introduced in production. A safe way to do so is to query for pending export changes across all of your connectors. To do a pending export query, you simply need to access the Synchronization Service Manager console of your staging server. On the Connectors tab, you will select each individual connector and click on Search Connector Space. In this view, you will change the scope to Pending Exports and select between Add, Modify, or Delete operations, then press Search to run your query. If changes are detected, this query will return a list of objects that can be inspected to view the operation and attribute that are pending changes. This report can also be exported for a more programmatic and detailed analysis. Now that you've determined that changes are expected, the staging server can be promoted as primary. Remember, you cannot have more than one server as primary, so it's important that you enable staging mode on your current primary before promoting any other server to that role. To enable staging mode, you must open the Azure AD Connect wizard and select the Configure Staging Mode option. You must authenticate against your Azure tenant with a role that has the necessary permissions to manage the provisioning configuration setup. After you are successfully authenticated, you can proceed next with the configuration. Here, you need to check the box that says Enable Staging Mode and go next. You will see a recap of the pending changes, along with the option to start a sync cycle after the configuration completes. Once the configuration task finishes, you receive a prompt that confirms staging mode was successfully enabled. You are now ready to promote the server with a newer version as your primary. This is done by following a similar process as before. You open the Azure AD Connect wizard and select Configure Staging Mode. You authenticate against your Azure Active Directory tenant. This time, you will uncheck the box that says Enable Staging Mode and go next. You will see a recap of the pending changes and select to start the sync process once these are completed. You can go ahead and click on Configure. You should see a prompt that confirms staging mode has been successfully disabled. Congratulations. You've successfully performed a SWE migration and safely upgraded your Azure AD Connect to the newer version. I hope this helps you better understand the SWE migration steps, along with the best practices that enable seamless upgrades across your hybrid environment. Thank you very much for watching.